Before that, though, the million-dollar question, or should I say euros, what should happen next with Brexit? Well, this man has walked 500 miles from his home in Germany to London, talking to British people along the way to find out why the UK voted to leave the EU. So our Brexit reporter, Mark Ashdown, caught up with him on the last leg of his journey.
Not a very political person. I felt I'm going to walk to London to really try to feel on the spot what's going on. It was actually April Fool's Day. It was the 1st of April.
So people thought you were joking.
So people thought I was joking, and I spent a sleepless night realizing what I was doing.
Right.
And so I walked up here, and then Strasbourg, then through these beautiful parts of Luxembourg, Mühlental, and a beautiful evening to Dover and to London, yeah. I wish to ask every person I meet from here, from Dover to London, what they think about the Brexit. Everyone against the Brexit?
Jesteście przeciwko Brexitowi?
We want our independence, and that's what Brexit means.
I was very moved by these, I would say, all very good people with genuine concern, but with totally divergent views in the one and in the other direction. So there's this strong English stoicism, which I admire.
Yeah.
What has to be delivered is something good for the public, something good for the people.
Yeah.
I haven't met one person who I didn't feel wasn't kind and good-hearted and warm-hearted, and that's what touched me all the more. Main kit were these shoes and these sandals. I have five different pairs of socks, and then the back, the shoulders sometimes feeling as if they were burning. I have some blisters, yes. My wife told me to take this scarf, and it's the best thing I did. And I have a jacket with me, and I'd be walking through the snow. Sometimes I would ask in the street, do you know of a good hostel, a good place to stay? And people would just offer me to stay at their house before I've even said what I'm doing. I lived in Britain as a teenager, and I love Britain. And I feel it's the gateway to Europe. And you're losing that advantage through Brexit.
No, I don't think. I think we will travel. We are not anti-Europe. We are anti the EU Commission. There is a difference.
What actually invites you to think that way?
Because it's a lose-lose situation.
Uh-huh.
Nobody's going to benefit from it. If England becomes isolated, we will be less safe, less secure, and we will be open to threat.
Thank you very much, and all the best. Their views go straight to my heart, and I really wonder what can be done. And I think for me, it boils down to paying much more attention to each other.
David Martin there's a song that comes to mind. Well, that chatter